everybody. Welcome back to another episode of 7 Days to Die, Darkness Falls. Woohoo! I don't know if my internet's going to be steady or reliable because it's been storming here for the last couple of days. And we had like an 18-hour outage of cell service, TV, and internet because a main fiber optic line, I guess, was cut somewhere between the Pacific Ocean and El Paso, Texas. And it was kind of like a rolling blackout for internet and phone services and stuff like that. So, doctors say that I'm about 98% recovered. There does appear to be some permanent nerve damage throughout my body, the right side of my body. But that's what happens when you have a stroke. It's like the right side of my tongue is numb all the time, and it's like it goes right down the center of my tongue. I can feel the left side of my tongue perfectly fine, but I've got that semi-novocaine feeling on the right side of my tongue. It's really bizarre. Got Discord starting to explode on me. I'm not streaming to Discord right at the moment. I stopped the recording last night thinking that I was going to have to restart the series because of the bug that I was having with these. Yeah, see, it's happening again. And I'm not sure why that's happening. like some tricks that I don't remember. I got real into 7 Days to Die for a while. Why is my voice getting so raspy all of a sudden? Weird. Oh. need the gold, silver, and diamond to upgrade my weapons and tools and stuff.
USS William B. Travis said, "Dang, that's got to suck."
Talk with somebody on Discord. Give me a minute.
USS William B. Travis said, "It's good to hear from you again, hope you get better."
Shaking the bushes.
USS William B. Travis said, "It is good to take it easy, but dang."
That is a butt ton.
Hello. How's it going?
It's going good. What about you?
Oh, not too bad. Been busy.
Yeah, I've just been sleeping a lot.
Man.
Yeah, it's kind of what happens.
Okay. Oh. What game you playing?
7 days today.
Never heard of it.
You ever seen it?
No.
Let me get to a safe place and I'll turn on my video.
See you, man.
It's sort of like Space Engineers without the space.
Hmm.
Discord. It's gonna kill my frame rate, but yeah, like I said, it's basically Space Engineers without the space. Same basic principles.
Well, tag zombies and shit too.
Yeah. I'm getting chased by screamers.
Oh no.
Yeah, I did a bunch of quick mining.
Oh.
And it drew out a bunch of screamers.
Sheesh.
And if I don't kill the screamers fast, the horde grows really quick.
Jeez.
Oh shit, I'm not stealth. That explains a lot. That's why they're still searching for me. There.
So the longer they chase after you, the more they grow?
Up the longer they chase you and the more they scream, because there's a chance that they can spawn as much as 64 zombies per screamer. So if,
64 per screamer?
Yeah, and sometimes you can get as many as 36 screamers at one time.
Jeez.
Yeah. So, if you don't kill them quick, you die fast. And because I'm playing Darkness Falls, there's no safe zones around, like, the stores and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And I build underground bases, usually just underneath the traders. And if I don't want the screamers to destroy the base, to hide long enough for him to stop searching for me and kill all the screamers within the vicinity.
Mm.
And then on the 30th day, it's horde night. So I go around and build and collect and make mazes underground and stuff like that and try to survive during horde night. Sometimes I make it, sometimes I don't.
Hey.
Because there's a lot to do, because you build weapons, you can farm, farm plants and hunt animals and that kind of stuff.
I was just trying to play War Thunder. Doing naval battles.
Yeah, Blue's one that normally plays out. I haven't played War Thunder in years. I played it for like the first 4 months it came out. But I haven't played it much since.
Yeah.
Okay, so.
Yeah, before yesterday, the last time I played it was back in 2017.
This is the wrong base.
The wrong base? What base is that?
This isn't. bases and a main base. So if I get overrun, the base gets destroyed, I have a backup base already ready, and I don't have to worry about, yeah, I just did a round robin. Oops.
Jeez.
Okay. So that explains a lot. Okay. But I'm here, I might be able to do it anyhow. I was trying to build upgrades for my weapons and stuff. But I needed diamonds. And I got 550 of them. Oh, speaking of which, do I have auger? We have specialized tools and stuff like that. And then I have my OP machete called the grass cutter that I'm using right now. It's a mod that I added. And then it's fully decked out. So it's my go-to melee weapon.
Huh.
And as you use it, it actually gives you stamina instead of takes it away.
Jeez. Oh, that's good.
Yeah, see, these are
a weapon that gives you stamina?
Yeah, it's the way that I've got the mod set up. Okay,
shit, I figured you got one of those motorcycles you was looking at, and
oh, because I do so much mining at the very beginning, I really don't use a vehicle. Because I also have another mod that allows me to access storage. It's a global storage, so wherever I have storage like this here. I have access to it no matter where I'm at. It's actually part of Darkness Falls. See, I'm running the test version of the Alpha 21 Darkness Falls. So there are strange bugs and stuff that you run into, and weird things that happen. Like, instead of it using up your resources, it just continually uses the same resources. It doesn't take away any when you use them.
That's a good bug.
Yes, I know.
No, I played a game that had something like that. I went to a trader to get some weapons, and there's no end to the ammunition. I just get them like several million of the frickin' 9mm ammo, and I bought me a tank and a helicopter.
Well, see, you have different storage, like this stuff right here. You can run around and collect. Ooh, titanium fire axe. Oh, that's a keeper. And this is a trader.
Let's see what he has. A nickel ain't worth a dime anymore.
Yep, a nickel isn't worth a dime anymore. That's absolutely true. The only bad thing about these traders is you can only sell 3 stacks of any one item at a time. Okay, that's all I'm gonna sell there. I can buy a duster. Get the coin, but
I guess you're not so bad after all.
Okay, so let's. Oh, crap.
Huh.
Screamer saw me.
Oh, man. I can tell you they found you.
Okay, if I'm not mistaken, I have to go all the way over here back up.
The live feed just plays a video, not the sound.
I just don't. No, there should be sound. I don't have it up very high, but.
That explains why I didn't hear any of the screamers or any of that.
You might also have to turn up my volume on your side on Discord. Mm. Discord's weird like that. Yeah, I was supposed to be heading towards that red marker, and I ended up going completely reverse of where I was headed.
Huh.
It's easy to get lost. If you don't pay attention to the map, but that's half the fun.
Yeah. So now the screamer guys know where your base is, or?
No, it's basically it's kind of there's an area, and then once you fall outside of a certain area or a certain block area, then the screamers basically just. Disappear, they despawn. But it will remember where they were, and every 10 days it'll reset where all the NPCs are. And I'm on the 7th day right now. But the number of zombies throughout the entire map will continue to accumulate for 10 days. And that's why it's important to kill them as you see them. Or just be really good at running.
Huh.
Because so, you'll typically run into the zombies like this. You'll usually have 6 or so that'll wolves, bears, birds, bugs. And they can come at you from underground, above ground, land, sea, and air. Kind of thing.
Huh. Animals attack you too?
Oh yeah. And then you have radiated animals and radiated zombies. Jeez. There you are. I heard him.
Jeez. Huh.
Okay, this is the main area for me right here. This is the base that I was building. And then decided I got sidetracked and forgot what I was going to build. And then I made myself a little watering area here so I could collect water, because you have to eat and drink as well.
Yeah.
I mean, so it is a survival game. But it's a lot like Space Engineers, or even a couple other games like Space Engineers. It's a survival crafting zombie game, basically. You explore the map, and now this looks like the same trader, but it's not. It's just a copy of the that same trader in a different location. They reuse resources. What do you expect for a game that will run on a 20-year-old computer?
This base is a bunch of caves and shit.
Yeah, see, I cut this all out. Building different areas. This is like my mining area for metal. And then I've got another section right here that I built. This is my impromptu building area. That's all my cooking stuff. Have different kinds of forges and workbenches and things like that that you make different things with. And then your different work tables have different tools that you add to the workbench, which will further allow you to make more stuff and better stuff. Different foods give you different buffs and different debuffs. Food Some things will give you, like dysentery, which will make all your water and food drain.
Jeez.
And when your water and food both get to zero, or either one of them get to zero, you start losing health. And then, of course, you have to watch out for disease and breaking bones and sprains and strains and biological problems.
Jeez.
You know, so there's a lot to it. It's single player and multiplayer. And that's what I like about it.
Yeah. You ever hear of Soldiers of Anarchy, a game?
Vaguely.
It's like Windows 95 or something. Good game. It's one of those post-apocalyptic things. And
well, that's kind of what 7 Days to Die is. But instead of it being a nuclear apocalypse, it's a zombie apocalypse. it's entertaining, you know.
Yeah. Keeps busy.
Yeah. So you you were working on your bike, right?
Yeah.
How's that coming along?
Oh, doing all right. I'm getting parts of the bed worked on, and mostly had flat tires, so that slowed my progress on working on the bike down. And
yeah, my wife decided to go to the store on her day off. And then go to the liquor store. She never made it to the liquor store.
Jeez.
Because she's got a 1993 Lincoln Continental.
Hmm.
The airbags popped.
What?
Yeah, the whole car slammed to the ground.
What?
Yeah, because it's an air ride suspension. Four-wheel air ride suspension.
Jeez.
And what it was is the safety valve blew. The valve that regulates pressure between the front tires and the back tires, that failed. And then when it failed, the car slammed on top of the tires, and it popped all four airbags.
Oh, dang.
Yeah. Scared.
Jeez.
Because and when it did, it crushed the exhaust pipe and punctured the catalytic converter.
Oh, damn.
Yeah.
Damn.
So, I mean, it just snowballed.
Jeez.
And the next day, it started thundering and lightning and storming. And it's been about a week and a half now.
Oh, man.
Poor thing. She's had to walk to work at 4 o'clock in the morning in the rain.
Oh, man. Oh, yeah. Man.
Now we have to save up, and that kind of blew our Christmas money. Because now we have to save whatever we can. But there is an upside. Hopefully, I will get approved for either disability or Social Security.
Fuck, a regulator for air suspension failed.
The safety valve, it failed. And the way it failed is it was an internal failure of there's a plunger inside a metered valve plunger thingy, and the seals popped. So it let all the air out, and it's not allowing the internal air compressor to keep the air.
Oh, man.
It's basically just like an open leak. And when when that happened, the air, it was a catastrophic release of all the air in the entire system, both front and back. So the entire car just slammed straight on top of the tires.
Oh, man.
Yeah, so you can basically say that that car's not worth anything anymore. It's totaled.
Man.
Because it's a unibody construction.
Oh, man. Day.
Well, Diana's had the car since it was brand new. It was a gift from her mother and her father before they passed away.
Man.
Well, before her father passed away. Mm-hmm. Her mother passed away a couple of years back.
Mm-hmm. Shit, I was thinking about getting air ride suspension, but damn.
If you do, make sure it's protected by coilovers. You know,
airbag, coil suspension.
Yeah, an airbag inside of coil suspension. So that way, if you do lose air pressure, you don't have the car slamming on top of the tires. Now, it's not going to be as bad if it's a full frame car. But when it happens in a unibody, you have like 320 different angles that you have to account for.
Oh, man.
Otherwise, you'll never get the car to align or to drive straight. It'll always look like it's driving sideways.
Man.
Yeah, that's why you'll see semis with air ride. They'll have like double and triple coils on the outside of the bags, or just in front of or in back. It's the same on the older generation Continentals and fancy cars with air ride suspension.
Basically, if you're going to have air ride, put it inside of a coil suspension and add a shock absorber.
Yeah, see, I've got a 1967 Mustang in the garage. I just need to put a carburetor on it and check the seals, change the oil, change fluids, that kind of thing, bleed the brakes, probably get new tires for it. And it's only got 36,000 miles on it.
Not too bad.
We paid like $14,000 to have the motor built from scratch.
Dang.
Out of Dang. A 351 Cleveland. A 1970 351 Cleveland. And the Mustang will do it. It's 800 horsepower car. She won't drive
it. She won't drive it. Jesus.
And it's not loud. It's very quiet. But the bodywork isn't done on it. My dad and I, we built it from the remnants of a 1967 Cougar that we were fully restoring. And the day that we were starting to do the bodywork, my dad took the Cougar to a car wash, a hand car wash, and he washed it. And he pulled out, and he's sitting there at a stoplight, and some lady was talking on a cell phone in a Cadillac Escalade, doing 55 miles an hour in a 15-mile-an-hour school zone, and slammed the ass end of the car.
Oh, dang.
Near killed my dad. Put him in the hospital for 4 months.
Fractured that 55-mile-an-hour?
Yeah. Fractured his neck, broke his back.
Jeez.
We had almost $180,000 invested in that car.
Man.
I mean, we restored it from the frame rails up. It had Krager magnesium rims on it. The split from 1955. We found two sets of them. junkyard. Brand new, never been opened.
Man.
And then we put a 1955 hot rod hood scoop on it.
Mm.
You know, it's just a small one. It's basically, it was a tunnel wrap. And then all the sequential taillights worked. The peekaboo headlights worked. The electronic seats.
Mm.
Those were fully restored. All the electronics were replaced. I rebuilt the shock tower, the front shock towers. And then put frame rail extensions.
Mm.
Front, back, left, and right. And then X'd them. And we hadn't quite completely done the interior because we're going to put a roll cage in it.
Huh.
And then my dad, and then we got the accident. So we took all the parts that we could from the Mustang and put them into the Cougar. Most everything except the driveline were cross-compatible because they were still the Fox body. It's just the XR7 was a little longer.
Hmm. Wow.
And you can't put traction bars or ladder bars on that Mustang. It'll break them every time. I've gone through about 15 sets. And this thing is set up to be a drag racing car. The only time you can spin the tires is if there's the slightest amount of moisture on the ground. And that's why the car got parked. It's because we had just moved into this house and I was working, I think about 70 miles from where we moved to. And I pulled out, because we live on a gravel road.
Mm.
And as soon as I got off the gravel road, and all I was doing is just making a right turn.
Mm.
The car spun three times and ended up in the culvert on the other side of the road.
What?
I lost traction.
Jeez.
So I promptly got my dad. He helped me pull the car out of the ditch, and I brought the car, parked inside the garage, put it up on jack stands, and I haven't driven it in like 13 years.
Jeez. Man.
And I'm used to race cars.
Yeah.
So I'm used to that kind of power and those kind of issues.
Hmm.
But, yeah, that's what I got with me and my dad tuning the car. So I parked it.
Oh, jeez.
You know, and it's a 1967 Mustang coupe, a California coupe.
Huh.
And it's a hot rod, so it's not something that we can get the money out of it that we put into it. But to the right person, they'll know what it's worth.
Mm.
And I've only been asking $5,000 for it.
Jeez.
And it's got a Lincoln Versailles posi rear end in it. Mm. With 350 gears. And the reason why we went to 350s is because it had 275s in it. Which meant that it would go over 240 miles an hour.
Jeez.
And it was clocked going that fast. Well, near that.
Jeez.
About 222.
Jeez.
So we took out the 275s, put in the 350s, and that made it slower, but it gave it more torque.
Oh.
They were going to put 411s in it, but we wouldn't be able to keep it on keep control. It'd spin out all the time.
Hey.
But it was just after we put the Lincoln Versailles rear end in that I spun out. And I think that's why. It's because the more torque you have, the more traction you have to have. And the Mustang only weighs maybe 3,000 pounds.
Yeah.
And that's because we took a whole saw and replaced body panels with lighter materials like fiberglass or carbon fiber, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
To make it as light as possible.
Yeah, cars are nice. And yeah, you know the world's fastest car of 2023 can do 330 mph.
See, when my dad and I built the Mustang, I think the fastest speed was, land speed record was like 294 miles an hour or something like that.
Yeah.
Until that lady that was on Mythbusters.
Carrie?
Yeah, that was before she had broke the land speed record and then tried it again and killed herself.
Dang.
Carrie Byron, it's another blonde. She was a racer chick. She's pretty famous. She was on Mythbusters and a car show. I can't remember the name of it.
What, Carrie Byron was the replacement?
No, she replaced Carrie Byron while Carrie Byron was pregnant. Or after Carrie Byron had her kid. She was one of the two replacements. I know her face. I just can't remember her name.
Okay,
so need... Yeah, see, this is another one of those examples where you make sure you continuously use the same resources.
Hey, Blue.
Afternoon.
I haven't seen you in forever.
I just woke up. When did you start in February? I went into hibernation.
I've actually been in bed, except for the rare times that I wasn't. I've pretty much just been in bed or streaming, but like in the last 4 days, I must have, spent 20 minutes in front of the computer, 25 minutes? I've been feeling like crap, and then the weather changed.
Yep.
Oh, I was just telling Travis, the air shocks on my wife's car blew. The regulator valve that controls pressure, front and back, it failed.
Yep.
And when it released all the air, it actually blew the airbags, crushed the catalytic converter, or punctured the catalytic converter.
Yep, you told me about that.
And tweaked the entire body of the car. So basically the car...
Oh, it's fucked.
Yeah, it's no longer safe to drive. Never will be.
So it's safe to drive in Oklahoma?
No, it's about your average Oklahoma car.
Yeah!
Man.
So she's had to walk in the rain for the last couple of weeks, to and from work. she's afraid to drive the Mustang. And I have two broken trucks. Neither one of them, well, if I got the transmission fixed on the automatic, she could drive that. But if I fixed the diesel, she can't drive that because it's a mechanical clutch. And it takes about 200 pounds to push in that clutch.
Okay. Move, cat.
It's got one of those Warren heavy-duty clutches in it.
Yep.
Now, if it was a hydraulic clutch, she'd be able to use it easy. But it's not. Because the diesel's a stick.
Hey, Cor, I'll be back in a couple minutes. I'm waiting for my computer to reboot. And with all the server background noise and being half tone deaf, I can barely hear you.
Well, Discord might have changed the volume too.
No, that's the thing. You're on my phone.
Oh, I
my
see.
My computer. So, and I'm sitting next to my server.
I gotcha. All right, see you in a bit.
I'm at 12% on this latest restart.
No worries.
Yep.
See you in a bit. Okay, so. Oh, yeah. I got the upgrades going. I need to find...
Well, if it takes 200 pounds to push in that clutch, sounds like she'd get a good workout.
Yeah, it's... But with her body, she's only like 5'2". And you have to push that clutch in almost 30 inches. So, yeah, I said that's a little much for her. Okay, so.
Because she's too short.
She is. She's really short. You can only get those from inside filing cabinets and places where you can find paper and trash. So yeah, it's a zombie looter shooter survival crafting game.
I'd say what you need on that game is either a tank or mobile artillery.
There, with this, there are those vehicles.
Yeah, if you run out of ammo, at least you can run over the zombies.
Yeah, but that damages your cars, and then you have to turn around and build repair kits to repair your car.
Man, run over zombies damages your car?
Well, think about it. Even in Death Race 2000, anytime you hit a pedestrian, it damages the car in some way.
Dang.
um.
I think they ought to have a Model T on there then.
Well, if you look on the screen, you can see that there are different cars like this one here. That's a military transport vehicle, so is that one. You have Chargers, you have motorcycles, airplanes, trikes, Humvees, cranes, four-wheel drives, semis.
Oh, that's what you need.
And then you have Jeeps and stuff like that, and then helicopters.
Helicopters, what you need for them zombies.
Well, that's to avoid the zombies.
Oh, those are to avoid them.
Yeah. But because there are helicopters in the game, you have super vultures.
What?
Which are basically dragons.
Huh? You got dragons?
No, they're zombie vultures, but they're basically as strong as dragons. And they can do AOE attacks and ranged attacks as well.
Put some machine guns and rocket launchers on the helicopter.
I'm not sure if there's vehicle-mounted weapons in the game yet.
Oh. So, basically, you got super vulture things that can do ranged attacks.
Yeah.
And you can't put guns on a helicopter?
No, but you have one person that's flying the vehicle, and you have other people that can shoot from the vehicle.
Hmm.
But like I said, it's a multiplayer game.
Yeah.
And then you have upgrades for your vehicles and stuff like that.
Sounds like you might want to avoid those vultures.
Well, see, the vultures, the super vultures, they only spawn in above a certain altitude. Otherwise, you're dealing with normal zombie vultures.
Normal zombie vultures.
Yeah. Which are pretty easy to kill. If you can hit them.
That's... Oh. Oh.
Well, because they fly. And they're pretty fast. Oh. And unless you're using a shotgun, it's pretty hard to shoot a moving target.
Hmm. So... On the ground, you got zombies. From what? About the ground to the tops of the trees, you got regular vultures. And above that is super vultures.
Yeah, and they can do block damage and they can dig.
Huh? They can dig too?
Yeah.
The hell?
That's why you always want to go around and kill all of the zombies in the local area, especially the screamers, and then go to your base.
Oh.
Because if you're underground, unless you're digging, you're not going to draw in as many zombies until Horde Night. Horde Night, you don't want to be underground. That's the worst place to be. I'll be right back. Bio break. Huh. This is the first time in 2 weeks we've had a ray of sunlight.
What?
Yeah, on one side of the house it's raining and cloudy. On the other side of the house it's sunny and dry.
Damn. Right on the edge of the cloud?
Yeah. The house, the clouds are splitting our house in half.
Shit.
It's not something you see all the time.
No. Huh. And before too long, I'm going to have to run to the store, but...
I'll still be here.
Yep. Yeah, good to hear from you again.
But yeah, it's been a while.
Yeah.
So, if... Hey, you're welcome to join anytime. But like I said, I haven't really been online much.
Yeah.
Past streaming for the last couple of weeks, I haven't really been feeling well. Okay, so I need a 225 receiver and the oil.
Yeah, I hope you get to feeling better.
Well, it's leukemia. It is what it is. I've got a whole slew of things that are going on with me, and they'll never go away. Mm. They're only going to get worse. You know, it's the life that I'm stuck with. I'm not complaining. Doesn't do me any good to complain. Nobody wants to hear it.
It don't really make the problem go away either.
I mean, there's, it's not bad enough for treatment. Unless I want to try stuff that's going to further damage my body. And
you'll get rid of the leukemia, but it'll damage your body.
Yeah, it's, I can't get rid of it. It's a genetic form of cancer. I've had it my entire life. And they diagnosed me with it a couple of years after I got out of the service. And I just kind of went, okay, if I've got it, I've got it. And it, up until a few years ago, it was never an issue. Until I started getting to the point where I just get so fatigued. And it's, I don't know if you've ever had surgery where they've had to give you a general anesthetic that knocks you out. But you get right to that point as the medicine hits you where you can't do anything but fall asleep. And it gets to that point, and then my body starts to hurt. My entire body. And it's like every inch of my body is getting pounded on by a spike club. And it's not a pleasant thing to go through.
I don't know.
But grandfather on my dad's side went through the same thing.
Oh, there's this chimeric antigen receptor T cell therapy. It's supposed to enhance the body's immune system and fight the cancer cells.
Well, see, that's the thing. The cancer's in my bone marrow. Because it's my bone marrow that's producing the smudge platelets that are the cancer cells. If it was a tumor, that kind of medicine would be effective.
Afternoon.
He's back. Hey. I'm not sure if I'm explaining it right, but it's something like that.
What is it explaining?
How my body's producing the smudge cells, the leukemia cells. In my bone marrow. He was talking about one of the newer toxins that came out. It's effective if it's a tumor cell or a tumor, but because mine's not tumorous cancer, it's mitochondria, bone marrow kind of thing. Different set of rules.
Basically, I can help you with this. Basically, instead of a tumor that's splitting and dividing and expanding itself, all of his bone marrow is producing the cancer.
Yeah, my entire bone marrow is the cancer.
And the only way to really, there's only one real cure for leukemia, but it's excruciatingly expensive and painful, because basically you have to kill all of your bone marrow and have a bone marrow positive match, which is like one in 100,000 people is a bone marrow match.
Yeah, and I'm 60 years old. I've had a good run. I've had a good life.
And the chances of him actually, to start with, if, for example, you'd have to take everybody on every Discord server that I'm part of, and I'm part of some pretty big Discord. There would be 5 people. Okay?
Yeah, basically, I made the decision to just live out the rest of my life without the extra added pain and suffering that and doctor bills. I might complain about it a lot sometimes,
when stuff hurts, it's easy to do.
Yeah, but it's...
Also, with all of his other health issues, he wouldn't even be forgetting his age if it was my age and he had all those health issues. He still would be ineligible for them.
The neck, the spine, the joints.
No. I'm talking about your strokes you're having. The stroke you had.
The strokes, the seizures,
The seizures, all that makes him ineligible for the transplant anyway. And basically, when everything boils down, it would take him 10 years fully recovered, and everything else that's wrong with him would kill him before he fully recovered.
Yeah, pretty much.
And he'd have to live in a bubble for 9 months. In that bubble, he would die.
I spent the first 3 years of my life, 2.5 years, from the time I was born, in one of those oxygen bubbles, because they found the issue, but they weren't able to understand what the issue was, and by the time after I got out of service, they had advanced, and they gave me gene therapy to increase my antibodies or something like that. But it was so early in my life, I don't necessarily remember it.
T-cell therapy thing was supposed to be cure leukemia, but...
Does, but by the price on him for to get it and his age makes him ineligible for getting the rest of his... If it, his diabetes doesn't kill him in the next 10 years...
It's not a tumorous form of leukemia.
Yeah.
It's a bone marrow form of leukemia.
Like, yeah, which is...
Like you said, the only way that I could do that is they'd have to give me radiation therapy to kill off all my bone marrow, and then
all
a bone marrow transplant.
And like I said, it would take years for him to recover, and by the time he fully recovers from it...
Everything else that's wrong with me is going to kill me anyway.
Yeah. So... The question, he's like my grandmother. Do you know what they wrote on the death certificate? Failure to thrive, because they really didn't know what killed her, because she had so many health issues.
Jeez.
Long story short, he's got so many health issues, it's a race to see which one killed him first.
Yeah, see, at best, I've got 30, 40 years left of my life.
Mm.
At worst, roughly 5 to 7.
Mm. I give him 10.
And it's... My dad died in my arms, and I took care of my dad for almost 28 years.
Mm.
Died with dignity.
Yeah.
And I want to die with that same kind of dignity, you know what I mean? He didn't become scared or fearful until the very end. The last five minutes, he was afraid.
Mm.
Because he felt his body shut down. Sniper rifle. Damn it. I keep on forgetting.
Make a sniper rifle?
Yeah.
Hey.
I have one, but it's too low quality. The higher the quality of the weapon, the more damage it does.
Oh, that's good. What caliber you got? A sniper rifle.
Well, this particular one in the game, it uses a 7.62.
Hmm.
Basically, it's a 30-06. But my sniper rifle, I have 3.
Hmm.
One of them's a 30-06, one of them's a 300 Win Mag, and one of them's 338 Federal.
Hmm. Pretty good.
Well, I'm gonna go check in on the other guys.
Okay.
Because I need to make sure that I've got the update secured for the other. Oh, also, Cor, me and Red are gonna be converting the. Oh, did I tell you about the new server?
I think we had talked about it.
Oh, this is another update.
Oh, no. I haven't heard about the newest.
So I ordered the new CPUs and discovered I ordered a 16 series versus the 26 series CPU, which I can only run in single CPU mode. So that was an order fuck. So instead, I'm saying fuck it in buying one of the best CPUs I can buy for it. And it's a little bit slower on base clock, but because it's this new generation of CPUs, it is what they call variable speed CPUs. So instead of all the cores moving as one unit, each core can boost up to its the clock it needs to save energy. And I'm buying two 22 core CPUs. So out of a or if I had the money, I could buy two 44 cores, I think they are.
Yep.
Let me check real quick.
Yeah,
2699 A, V4.
I'm going to mute my mic and head to the store.
Alrighty, see you in a bit.
See you in a bit. Sorry, I'm buying 20 cores.
20 cores? Holy crap.
20 cores. Two of them. And they multi-thread into 44 threads.
Holy crap.
And Red's gonna help me set up virtualization on the system. So with a game panel and all that, so that I can subdivide it, and instead of giving access to the core server itself, I can give each server its own panel, effectively. You get what I'm saying?
Nice.
So, when I move the base engineer server over to it, I can give it a handful of cores it needs, which is like 12 cores of its own power, but nobody else can access the data or anything except for people who have access to that panel.
Oh, nice.
And I'm thinking about using that the old server as a caching server, which allows me to have basically all the games I need for the panel to basically have them on hand as needed.
Yeah, just use it as a file server.
Yeah, which it has 16 terabytes worth of storage for.
Which is plenty good enough.
Yeah. 16 usable terabytes of storage. Which is more than enough. So, I can store all the game servers I need on it, so that when they update automatically, every day, they can just update, and instead of having to re-download them, they just pull them from the cache. Which saves in bandwidth.
Saves in a lot of things.
And I'm buying a managed switch with failover. So basically, I can run all games on one internet, and then the other internet used for my personal use and for downloading the updates for the game service.
Wow, that's complicated.
It sounds complicated, but it's really not.
Yeah, my brain's exploding.
Well, the simplicity is basically if one internet connection goes down, they both don't go down, so they can keep running.
Oh, that reminds me. There was one full day I had no internet, no cell phone, no TV, no nothing.
Oh.
And I called into Spectrum, and I said, hey, I've got no internet. I've not changed anything. My computer said I lost internet at 11:25, and I'm calling you at 9:25, and I still don't have internet. And they kept on telling me, well, we have to have a technician. I said, I'm telling you, it's not my equipment. It's something on your end. turns out that either it was the same fiber optics cable that was severed in El Paso in multiple locations.
Oh!
Almost in unison.
There have been a lot of attacks on the fiber network lately by a conservative group.
That's because they're trying to infiltrate the American internet. And the best way to do that is a hardwire connection.
Nope. They're attacking. You notice what I said. Conservative groups are attacking the fiber optic.
Oh yeah, it's terrorist.
Yeah, it's the extremist right wing.
I'm not saying. I think it's a left wing.
No, they're actual right wing extremists.
No, I think it's the left wing. It's because the left wing is controlling the government already.
No, that's the thing. These cells are. Trust me, from the inside, I can tell you that they're extremist right wing groups. They believe that the internet is the fall of society, and anyone using the internet is not a true American.
Since when?
That's what these groups believe that are attacking this. That's their manifesto. You think I'm kidding either?
Seeing that the federal government has been doing, I am surprised the assassinations haven't started.
Oh, I am very surprised. Oh, and you want to know what's funny? Do you know why these groups aren't assassinating the president?
Or other government officials?
Well, to start with, the president. Which one would you rather have in office? Joe Biden or Kamala Harris?
No, thank you.
If you had to make a choice right now, which
Mickey
one would
Mouse.
You rather have?
Mickey Mouse.
Yeah. Personally, I'd choose Biden, who's incompetent, over Kamala Harris, who is a competent person, but the exact opposite of what America.
Well, we only have, what, another year to go before his term's up?
If that. No, it's,
it's actually a year from today.
I thought the election was this year, and they get put in office 2024. Okay. I couldn't remember, so so it is about a year from today, yeah.
Yeah, because it's November 6th.
Yep.
That's funny.
To be honest, tell me Biden hasn't been a lame duck for 4 years.
I will say I am unhappy with our current government and all its iterations. Over the last 3.5 years.
I've been unhappy with the government for the last 12 years. And those are all the votes that I've been... That I voted for Romney over Obama.
Yes, I didn't like Romney either.
I liked Romney. He was a businessman.
That's one of the same reasons why I like Trump. Now, here's something to consider.
Okay.
Who is going to be better at their job? Somebody that has only succeeded 10 times out of 1,000 attempts, or somebody that succeeded all 10 times?
Oh, did you hear about the latest thing about Forbes? Yeah, Forbes has removed Trump from the top 500 list. Do you know why?
They're trying to cancel him without killing him.
No. Do you know why Trump was removed from the top 500 list?
Nope.
That one of his properties was supposed to be, like, for example, his penthouse that he owned in Trump Tower, a comparable apartment in a newer skyscraper in New York. Okay? Because these are, I'm talking about square footage, penthouse in a skyscraper. You get what I'm saying? Like, these are apples to apples comparisons. The only difference is this tower is like 20 years newer. How much less than what Trump evaluated in his tower, penthouse, do you think the difference was?
It is just people playing games.
No. This penthouse sold for $160,000. Trump evaluated his penthouse at $3 million. Also, Mar-a-Lago. Do you know why Mar-a-Lago valuation dropped?
I can tell you straight up that they are trying to destroy Trump without actually assassinating him.
Yep, I know this, but do you know who reevaluated Trump's Mar-a-Lago estate?
Probably Kamala Harris.
No! I think it was, who's the governor of Florida? Ron DeSantis. Okay? Ron DeSantis, a extreme Republican, about reevaluated.
Ron DeSantis is a financial analyst.
Wait. Oh, that's the thing.
Hold on. Oh my god. That is the funniest damn thing I have heard in a long time.
Wait.
Fuck.
Him and his advisors reevaluated that because you cannot, because Trump, wait, I'm not done yet.
You just can't make this shit up, can you?
No, I'm not. Okay, so Ron DeSantis and his advisors reevaluated.
This is so obvious. What's happening is completely obvious.
Wait, let me finish. Finish on this. Him and his advisors, when Trump bought Mar-a-Lago, do you know why Trump bought Mar-a-Lago for such a price?
I remember an interview.
Because Trump signed a piece. Trump signed this paperwork in Florida, with his lawyer, okay? And Trump admitted to it, signing this piece of paperwork, okay, in court.
Right. What they're okay? doing is because of a law this one lady wrote that set a precedent that said that you can make a new law and recognize that when the law was different, somebody did something that was legal at that time and then charged them with the crime when it was legal at a future date, just because they changed the law.
Okay, so what the law, so the piece of paperwork said that Mar-a-Lago's, the estate of Mar-a-Lago, can no longer be developed beyond what it currently is.
So, for example, I bought a gun.
Yep.
10 years ago. And it was legal for me to purchase that gun.
Yep.
But now, because, and I've taken the same medicine for 10 years.
Yep.
Okay. But now, they're trying to pass a law that says because I take one type of medicine, that is used for, but not only for, depression, I can no longer purchase that gun, and now they're charging me with a federal felony gun crime because I made that purchase 10 years ago.
Okay. So,
that's
you know, Lynn,
that they're doing to Trump.
Okay. Now, listen to me for a few minutes, okay? Will you give me that?
Yeah.
Okay. So, imagine your property. You know the one in Oregon, or the one you haven't developed as much. Okay? You know how you can't legally develop what they call wetland property? Like, you can't build in the middle of a swamp.
That's not true.
In a lot of states, including Florida, you can't build physically in the middle of a swamp. That's protected wetland.
Oh, if it's protected, you can't.
Yes.
Any protected lands.
Yep, this is protected wetland. Imagine 90% of your property is protected wetland. You can't develop that, right?
Was the property purchased before it was protected wetlands?
He purchased it under the investors that helped him purchase it when he originally bought it were under the, basically he told them that it was going to be able to develop. Okay? Then soon as he went to purchase it, he signed a piece of paperwork stating that he acknowledged that this is protected wetlands and that it cannot be developed. Okay.
Yeah, there's something about that that doesn't make sense.
That's the thing. And Trump and his lawyers are not fighting the fact that he signed this paperwork. Okay? That's the thing.
They're going to find a way to make it a federal felony for Trump to breathe air.
Yeah, just hear me out. Hear me out. Also, New York is the only one, which has 90% of the investors that Trump was using. That's where they're based. So New York is suing them under deceptive investor practice. Even though Trump has paid 100% of these investors back, this is something that everybody does. At that time, when he bought it, this is a common practice.
Yeah.
But they're going after him for it.
Uh-huh.
Okay? Okay? You notice I'm not saying anything that could be... No, you get what I'm saying. I'm not saying that
yeah,
you
not,
did anything
you're not,
wrong.
You're not Trump-hating. I get it.
I'm just stating facts. That's all I'm doing. If you or me did this, nobody would care because the banks got paid. But because it's him, and he's up for 1,000, up for 88 other charges of doing the same thing in different places, doing different properties, different, you get what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
Also, when he evaluated Mar-a-Lago, for the investors, he evaluated it with his financial advisors, which Trump is suing the bank for evaluating it like that. And the banks that are for investors are suing him for improperly disclosing information for the evaluation. Because this piece of paperwork was a linchpin on whether or not they were going to invest for that property.
Yeah, this is, it's, I'm, you don't even have to continue. It's still part of the political assassination of Trump.
Oh, I'll agree with that. But the thing is, but Mar-a-Lago evaluation was originally set at $5 million, what the estate would have been worth, if it was developable with the chance of it being up to hundreds of millions of dollars at this time. But because 90 some odd percent, I'll look it up if you need me to, of this property is protected wetland, except for the pump that he has developed as Mar-a-Lago. You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, see, I own 10 acres of protected forest reserve.
And you can't develop it.
No, not unless I get a change of venue.
Yeah. My brother owns 14 acres of protected wildlife reserve, which my brother's fighting the town again. Do you know why?
Nope.
When my brother purchased the property from my grandfather never signed the paper. His neighbors delegated his property as protected to prevent him from developing, my grandfather from developing that piece of property.
Yeah, that kind of shitty stuff on its face.
So, my brother has gone to the town and the particular neighbor that signed it, make the paperwork, my brother has signed paperwork to delegate their horse, the VTC horse ranch, which is a college, and which is a big college, as protected wetlands because it's wet for more than 6 months of the year. So right now, DTC can't run their. They bought this multi-million-dollar property in Vermont, and they can't do it unless VGC releases the paperwork against my brother. My brother will drop the paperwork. Do you know how he did it?
Nope.
It snows in Vermont.
Shit. That's funny.
and it starts snowing in December, okay? So that makes the ground wet, right? And then it doesn't thaw out until early May. That's 5 months, because it's end of December. Then it doesn't fully dry out until late May, mid-June. So it's a wetland for 6 months of the year. All these fields. And you know what my brother's fighting for? His legal right of way, which has paperwork stating that that's his legal right of way. He has two legal right of ways in his property. One of them he can't use because of where he wants to build his house. Because the amount of money it would cost to run down one, basically it's a giant square chunk of property offset from all the roads. One of them runs down the side of a field. Okay. Down the edge of the field. And to a road. And the other one, you have to cross a river, or not a river, but a brook.